Hello! Welcome to Little Smiles Basic 2 online tutorials. Today's tutorial is on English language. Taking from strand 6, using writing convention or grammar usage. Sub-strand 3, using action words. Indicator 1. Use the simple present tense to express habitual actions. You are to use the simple present tense to express habitual actions. In today's lesson or tutorials, we are going to look at the simple present tense. But before then, we are going to look at action words, which are the same as verbs. What is a verb? A verb is a word that expresses an action. A verb is a word that expresses an action. It can express what people, animals, and things do. A verb expresses an action. All words that you can act is a verb. For example, clap. I'm acting. I'm clapping. So clap is a verb. Write. I am writing, I'm performing an action. So write is a verb. As I'm talking now, I'm doing an action. So talk is a verb. Let's look at examples of verbs. Eat, work, play, learn, write, drink, read, write, dance, sweep, etc. All these are examples of action words. All these words, you can ask them. So they are all verbs. Now, we are looking at simple present tense in today's lesson. What is a tense? The tense of a verb tells when the action takes place. The tense of a verb tells when the action takes place. Verbs can be in the present or past. Tense of a verb tells when an action is taking place. Actions can take place in the present or in the past. Now, let's look at the simple present tense. The simple present tense. The present tense is used to express an action that takes place after or always. Any action that takes place after or always is in the simple present tense. I go to school always. I read my Bible every Sunday. I wash my clothes every Saturday. All these are actions taking place all the time. So this is what we mean by the simple present tense, or actions taking place in the present tense. Some of the words, that is the third person singular, takes S or ES. Words in the simple present tense. When the third person or when they are in the third person singular, they take an S after the verb or ES. And these are the simple present tense or the third person singular words. We have he, she, the third person singular, all the verbs, some of the verbs take S at the end or ES. Let's go to this table and look at how to construct some of the verbs. Now, let's look at the first column of the table before we come to the other columns. I, we have I, you, he, Kofi is the same as he, Ali is the same as he, my father is the same as he, daddy is the same as he, she, Ama is a she, Mary is a she, my mother is a she, mommy is a she. Let's come to it. The dog is the same as it. The cat is the same as it. The animal is the same as it. You also have you, referring to somebody. We, Aku and I is the same as we. Mother and I is the same as we. Teacher and I is the same as we. They, more than two people. Kofi and Ama is the same as they. The children is the same as they. The pupils is the same as they. Now, let's look at the verbs. We have teach and sing. We are going to construct them. When we get to the third person singular, some of the verbs take S and some take ES. You have to note that. So let's begin with teach. I teach. You teach. He teaches. It takes what? ES. Kofi teaches. My father teaches. Debbie teaches. She teaches. My mother teaches. Mary teaches. It teaches. The dog teaches. The animal teaches. You teach. We teach. Aku and I teach. Mother and I teach. They teach. Kofi and Ama teach. The children teach. The pupils teach. Let's look at sing. I sing. You sing. He sings. We add S in the third person singular. Kofi sings. Daddy sings. She sings. Mommy sings. My mother sings. It sings. The cat sings. You sing. No S. We sing. Aku and I sing. Teacher and I sing. They sing. The children sing. The pupils sing. Good. Children, I hope after going through this table, you'll be able to know how to construct verbs and when to add ES and when to add S in the third person singular. Below this tutorial, download this exercise. Answer them and submit for marking at the school premises. We'll meet again in our next tutorial. Bye-bye.